Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 10 features on your Mac that could save you time. MacMost is brought to you thanks to more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So there are a lot of features built into Mac OS that can save you time if you learn how to use them. Let's start with the most obvious one. Keyboard shortcuts. Most of the things you need to do in most apps can be found in the commands in the menu bar at the top. And many of these have keyboard shortcuts. If you look through the menus, you'll see the keyboard shortcuts here to the right of each command. The key to using shortcuts effectively is when you notice yourself using a command over and over again, note what the keyboard shortcut is. Then the next time you find yourself going to the menu, don't use the menu. Look at the keyboard shortcut, release the menu, and then use the keyboard shortcut. After forcing yourself to do that a few times, you'll quickly learn that keyboard shortcut and save time from that point on. You could also go into System Preferences, Keyboard, Shortcuts, and here you could set custom shortcuts by going to App Shortcuts and defining a custom shortcut using the exact name of the menu command that you want. So even if there's no keyboard shortcut for that item right now, you can add one. Now another problem with menu commands is sometimes you don't remember where something is. So you end up searching for it and wasting a lot of time doing that. For instance, in Pages, if I wanted to make something superscript, I would have to look around for that. It's hidden down in Format, Font, Baseline, and there's Superscript. But an easier way to get to that would be to click on the Help menu, and then I could just search for it. As soon as I type 3 characters, I could see where it is, and I can actually trigger it from here or learn its location by looking at where it's indicating. But better yet, a keyboard shortcut will get me there, so I never have to lift my fingers off the keyboard. Command, Shift, and question mark will bring up the Help menu, and then I just type, and then I can use down arrow to go to it and a return to select. It even remembers the last search, so if I go there again, the command is there. So if I need to use it 2 or 3 times in a row, I can just go to the Help menu instead of digging down to find the command. You can do some shortcuts without even using the keyboard though. If you go into System Preferences and then Mission Control, click on the Hot Corners button, and you can assign a shortcut to each of the 4 corners of the screen. So for instance, if I wanted to assign something to the bottom right, I could click here and assign one of these shortcuts to it. So I can instantly have Launchpad come up, for instance, when I go there, or put the display to sleep. If you hold down one of the modifier keys, like Command, you see I can change it. So I have to hold the Command key down when I go to the corner, which makes it harder to trigger by accident. Another time-saving feature is the App Switcher. Most of the time when you're going to a different app, you're going to an app that you already have running. And macOS memory management is very good, so there's usually no reason to quit an app unless you're not going to be using it for a long while. So you can leave things like Safari and Mail running all the time. And then to get to it, instead of having to go to the dock or Spotlight to launch the app again, you could just use Command Tab, continue to hold the Command key down while you tab to the app that you want, and then release the Command key to jump to the app. Then the only time you ever need to use the dock, Spotlight, or Launchpad to launch an app is when you want to go to an app that you don't currently have running. So there are a lot of built-in features that help you type faster. If you're not good at typing, you may want to look into using dictation. There are 2 types of dictation built into Mac OS. The simple type you can find in System Preferences under Keyboard and then Dictation. Turn that on, and now you can use the keyboard shortcut, in this case press Control key twice, to activate it. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. More advanced dictation is available in System Preferences, and then Accessibility, and then go to Voice Control. Then if you enable Voice Control, you could do even more with dictation, including custom vocabulary and lots of different commands. Your Mac also has something called QuickType, which is kind of like autocomplete. If you type part of a word, and then you use either Option Escape or F5, it brings up these suggestions. You can use the arrow keys to go through them and return to select one. If you want to use F5, you may need to use the FN key in addition to F5, depending upon your keyboard settings. And then, of course, there are text replacements. They are under System Preferences, Keyboard, and then go to Text. And here you can suggest a word that you type and then something to replace it with. and it could be something quite long. So for instance, if you find yourself typing the same thing over and over again, you could set something up like this. And now all I need to do is type these three letters followed by like a space or a return, and I get the phrase. So how about in the Finder? Here are some things that make using the Finder a little faster. One is favorites here on the left. A lot of people just leave these at the default. But if you have folders that you're going to all the time, you're going to want to add them here to favorites. For instance, let me add this folder here. I'll just drag it over and I'll put it where I want. Now to go to that folder in any Finder window, all I need to do is click on that and it goes to it. Also, if I want to drag and drop something into that folder, I can drag it into the sidebar. Not only that, but the favorites appear in an open or save dialog in an app. You can see it here. So I could jump right to that folder when opening or saving a file. Also, there are two recents functions that you should know about. One is to have recents here in favorites. Most of the time when you want to open a file, it was a file you were just working with in the last day or so. So going to recents will give you a list sorted by date last opened, and most of the time you could find the file you want right there. There's no need to remember where it is you saved it. If you don't see recents under favorites, go to Finder, Preferences, and then under Sidebar, make sure Recents is checked. But there are also recent functions in other places. Like in the Apple menu, you could see recent items, and it'll show you recent applications and documents. You can easily open those files. And in apps, if you go to File, they'll be Open Recent, and it will show you the most recently accessed files. Here's a feature that should be obvious to most, but a lot of people go and use Spotlight, Command Space, to search for files. But Spotlight actually gives you results for all sorts of things. Applications, emails, fonts, tons of stuff, and it makes it a little bit slow. If you know you want to find a file, instead of using Command Space, do Command Option Space, and that will open up a new Finder window or tab and allow you to start searching just for files. And since it's not looking for other things like Spotlight is, it could be a lot faster. And here are some bonus ones. The Finder has a batch rename feature, which could save you a lot of time. Like suppose I wanted to change all of the files with the word notes in it to say stuff instead of notes. I could select these, and then if I go to File, Rename, it will actually bring up a batch rename tool. This only appears if you've got more than one file selected. So now, for instance, I could say replace text and find notes and replace with stuff. Gives me an example there. I rename, and you could see how it renamed all those files at once. And here's one last one. And I may do a tutorial on just this in the future, but Siri can save you a lot of time. Like for instance, say I wanted to add a reminder. I could go to the Reminders app, have that launch, then I could go to the reminders list I want, then hit the plus button, and then type a reminder. And then I would have to go and add date and add something to it, maybe add a time. A lot of steps to do it. But Siri can do it with just one voice command. Remind me to check my statistics today at 3 p.m.
Done.
So you can see how it created the reminder, put it in my default list, and set a time for it all in one go. You could add calendar events. You could start an email. Send an email to Joe.
What's the subject of your email?
Our meeting today.
What would you like your email to say?
Looking forward to seeing you today.
Here's your message to Joe Mac.
So you can see how I definitely was able to make that email and send it faster than if I would have typed it out. So I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.